She stay on my dorm, she gon' pull on me. Pull like weed, entice me. She my queen. Eh, oh, eh, oh, eh. She my queen. Eh, oh, eh, oh, eh.
Hey guys, this is Chrissy Speaks, and I want to officially welcome you back to my channel. Now, this video is gonna be a little different. My heart has been heavy. This week has been crazy. We're still in quarantine, and it just seems like everybody's social media is the news. But there are three specific individuals that have stood out to me. First one being 25-year-old Ahmaud Arbery. He was jogging on February 23rd and was murdered by a white father and son who claimed that he looked suspicious. So should we all just kill people who we think look suspicious? I wear black every day. I wear a black hat, I wear black sunglasses, and half of the time I'm not smiling because it's cold and I live in New York. Should I be killed because I look suspicious? Secondly, Breonna Taylor, an EMT and essential worker at two hospitals who was shot 8 times and killed in her home by 3 officers wearing plain clothes who didn't even identify themselves. How does one walk into someone's crib and just start shooting them? I guess it's okay when you look like me. Third, George Floyd. He recently died after pleading with officers that he could not breathe while an officer held him down with a knee on his neck for nearly 5 minutes. Does this not sound like Eric Gardner? I cannot breathe. It's crazy to me. Now, these are just 3 individuals that I named that have caught national attention. It's just 3. So imagine the ones that are dead, dying, the ones that we actually don't know about because none of this stuff is on camera. Speaking of camera, I've had a conversation with multiple people and we've all had similar thoughts and similar discussions like, how are you just gonna record people getting murdered and not do anything? But then one should also ask, how can you call the police on the police? It's crazy, and I feel like a lot of us are being traumatized. The whole thing is numb. What do you do? I mean, the George Floyd one, there's no difference from the knee on his neck from the black men that were lynched, the black men and women who were lynched from trees. The whole thing is just very disturbing. It's disturbing. And the way it's justified, it's evil. It's not real, real talk, it's evil. So if that isn't messed up enough, some of the consequences that these officers face are desk duty, suspension, or sometimes just administrative leave. Translation. Let me just say this and do this so y'all can forget, like y'all always do. Just shut them up. Nobody ever faces jail time. They don't ever face jail time. So I'm curious, black officers who work with these same people, who disregard the lives of people who look like you, what do you do? What do you say? What does that environment look like? White people who say, girl, all lives matter, and I'm not racist, I got black friends. What do you say? What do you do? Or do you continue to scroll and put the sad face emoji? That sucks, that really sucks. Yeah, that's crazy. Y'all just keep getting killed. Black people, my people, what do we say? What do we do? It's almost like it's prayer versus protest, coronavirus versus the police, police versus the iPhone, and so on. What do we do as a people? This week literally has made me just want to silence all of my social media, all of my devices, and just have like a mental break. It's uncomfortable. It is messed up. It's sad, but it's always sad. It's always messed up. So let me know your thoughts. I'm not trying to make no depressing video, but these conversations need to be had. Is America canceled? What do we do? Because clearly nothing is working. What are some of the changes that you want to see? I'm Chrissy Speaks, and I have spoken.